Shad Gaspard's last act on this earth was to tell the lifeguards who made it to him first to go and get his son. Is there a more heroic act? Shad to Uriah is already a superhero, and now that's, you know, his dad is the ultimate hero.
He would always write son, and when he's talking about his son, S-U-N, because he meant, his son meant so much to him, as he was this light, this powerful, like the way he loved his son, the way he spent time with him was really beautiful to see.
I'm not a dad. I can't imagine what it would feel like. I know a few of the dads have said we all like to believe, you know, we'd make that choice, make sure our son's okay or our daughter's okay before us, but he showed the world without hesitation what kind of man he was right there.
That selfless act of, you know, save my child, that's the ultimate hero. That's something that Shad should always be remembered for.
He made a very nice post this past year at WrestleMania, and it was a match involving Shad, JTG, and Eve against myself, Natalya, and David Hart Smith. And he said, like, TJ, even now, he has one of the greatest minds in wrestling, and even now with a broken neck, he would run circles around 99.9% of the guys, and like, man, it'll get me emotional. But to see those were his true thoughts about me. That meant the world to me.
I met Shad when I first got to OVW back in 2004. Remember after practice one day, Shad just called me up out of the blue and he was like, hey man, a lot of us are getting together. We're gonna go have some drinks down here. And Shad picked me up, and Shad was one of those guys, when you go out with him, Shad just kind of hovers around everyone. And he's kind of like that protector, but yet that person that makes sure everybody has a good time. And that's what he did for me. So he kind of like welcomed me into the group. Shad's just gonna be missed, man. He's gonna be missed forever.
I always remembered in the matches that I was in with Shad, he always wanted to make sure that I was included. He always wanted to make sure that I was involved. He really cared about me. He cared about me being included, and that meant so much to me because he didn't have to fight for me on a lot of things.
It's a good reminder for all of us to live our lives the way that Shad lived his, with passion, with enthusiasm, super optimistic, you know? And it just warms my heart every time I hear stories of Shad, because it just kind of further, you know, emphasizes just how much of an impact and a positive impact he had on all of us.
He was a lovable human being, just happy. Each and every day he walked through these doors coming to work. And Matt and I, you know, I always dreamed of a feud with Crime Time, man. We didn't ever get to have it, but man, I'm blessed that I had the pleasure of knowing him.
He wanted everybody he was around to make sure he went around almost like a concierge saying, are you good? You good? You having fun? And a lot of times we were very lucky. The Kentucky Derby was in Louisville, and it was a big weekend. And he wanted to go around and make sure everybody was taken care of, everybody was having a good time. And it's just, like, he wasn't just like that on those days. He was like that all the time. And a lot of people are very lucky that he was in their life.
You know, you never really realize how many people that Shad touched. Obviously, the wrestling world was reeling. But while out in California, spending time with his family and just seeing all the outpour of just guys in movies, guys in TV, the bodybuilding world. I mean, it's actually been unbelievable. That's the only way I can put it.
Thinking about all the stories and memories I have, with him, I realized, like, man, like, he loved me, you know? He treated me like family. And I hope he knew that I loved him right back. And I wish that I'd had a chance to tell him how I felt about him and how much he's done for me personally before he passed. But You gotta believe that Shad's big ass is up there somewhere looking down and enjoying life. He wouldn't want anyone to be sad for him. He would probably just want people to make dumb jokes and laugh about all the good times that they had with him.